Today we are going to solve this quadratic equation using factorization method. This method is also called splitting the middle term by the students. This is question number 1, 3x squared minus x minus 2 equal to 0. And let's discuss how to solve this using factorization method. In this method, we multiply this constant term with the coefficient of x squared. The coefficient of x squared is 3 and the constant term is 2. 3 multiplied by 2 is, this gives us the 6 answer. The next step is we have to make the factor of 6. So the factor of 6 is 1 times 6 and 2 times 3. And then it is 3 times 2. 2 times 3 and 3 times 2, these are the same factors. So once you get the same factor, you should stop over there. So we don't write 3 over 2 because we already have 2 multiply by 3. Now we have, this is first pair of factor and this is second pair of factor. And we have to select one pair of factor. To decide which pair of factor we should select, we should see the sign of this constant term. The sign of the constant term is minus sign. And we have to also see what is the coefficient of this x. The coefficient of this x is minus 1. This is minus 1. Therefore, we have to select that pair of the factor out of these two factors. When we subtract that pair, the answer should be minus 1. Hence, if we subtract 6 minus 1, the answer is 5. So this is not the required factor. If we subtract 3 minus 2, we will get 1 here. So this is the required factor here. In the next step, third step, so what you have to do, this 3x squared will come as it is. This minus will come as it is. And here for this x, you should split this x into this part. So here, first you have to pick this pair of factor, and from this pair of factor, write the larger number first. Put the brackets and write the larger number first. In this pair of factor, 3 is the larger number. So 3x will come first and then it will come minus 2. So we have written here 3x minus 2. We wrote minus here because we have to subtract the factors. We have decided that we have to subtract the factors. In the next step, we are going to open the brackets. This minus and the plus 3 will become minus 3. And minus 2 will become plus 2. Now we have here 4 terms. We will convert those 4 terms into 2 groups. And we will take common from this first group, which is 3x common here. And there is x minus 1 left. In the second group, we will take plus 2 common. And we will get x minus 1 again. And from this equation, x minus 1 is common. We took x minus 1 common here. Then 3x left here. And plus 2 left here. So this is factorization of the equation, this one. In the next, what we do here, we will put this x minus 1 equal to 0 and 3x plus 2 equal to 0. From this one, from this equation, we will get x is equal to 1. And from this equation, we will get the answer minus 2 over 3. Let's solve the second example. Here we have another question. 5x squared minus 13x plus 6 is equal to 0. We are going to solve this quadratic equation using factorization method. So the first step is we have to multiply this constant term with the coefficient of x squared. So 6 multiply 5, it will give us 30. In the second step, we are going to make the factors of 30. So it is 1 times 30, 2 times 15, 3 times 10, 5 times 6, and 6 times 5. We don't take 6 times 5 because we have already taken 5 times 6. So we have, as we discussed in the first example, when the factors start repeating again, we should stop over there. So we will not use 6 multiply 5 because we already have 5 multiply 6. Now we have to decide which pair of factor we have to select, because we have 4 pairs of factor. This is first pair, second pair, third pair, and this is fourth pair of the factors. Now we have to decide which pair we should select. To decide which pair we have to select, we have to see what is the sign of constant term. The sign of the constant term is positive here, and the coefficient of x is minus 13. So therefore we have to select that pair of the factor out of these 4 factors. If we add that pair of factor, the answer should be minus 13. So if you see here, if you add these two, the answer will be 31. So this is not the required factor. If you add these two, the answer is 17. This is also not the required factor. But if you add these two, 3 and 10, your answer will be 13. So this is the required pair of factor. Next, what we do here? We write this 5x squared as it is, negative sign as it is. And now we put bracket here. And we should write the larger factor first. So we will write 10x first and then 3x here later on. And there will be plus sign between them. It is plus because we have discussed to add the factor. We will have to add. So we will use plus sign here. In the next step, open the bracket. So it is minus and the 10 is plus. Minus into plus is minus 10. And it is plus 3 and it is minus sign outside. Minus into plus is minus here. Now there are 4 terms. 1, 2, 3, 4. We have divided these into 2 groups. This is blue group and this is red group. From the blue group you can see 5x is common. We took 5x common, then x minus 2 left, and from this group we took minus 3 common, because when you take minus common, the sign will change inside the bracket. It is plus, it will become minus, and it is minus, it will become plus. Now we have x minus 2 and x minus 2, same factor over here. If we don't have x minus 2 and x minus 2, they are not the same. So it's mean we are not going on the straight path. There is some mistake in the question. Remember, these two factors should be same. So from this equation, x minus 2 and x minus 2 is same. We will take x minus 2 common. When we take x minus 2 common from here, 5x left here. When we take x minus 2 common from here, minus 3 left here. So minus 3 is over here. So this is the factors of this quadratic equation. In the next step, what we'll do here, we'll put x minus 2 equal to 0 right now here, and 5x minus 3 equal to 0. From this equation we will get 2, and from here we will get 3 over 5. So this is how we can solve a quadratic equation using factorization method, and this method is also called splitting the middle term method.
Press the subscribe button and don't forget to press the bell button for upcoming new videos.